Hello fellow engineers, and today we are checking out Core, who I'm very pleased to announce are sponsoring this video. If you don't know what Core is, basically it's an online platform available on the Epic Game Store that allows you to play and create your very own games for free. Yes, free! If you're interested in making your own games, this is a great way to start as you don't need to know how to code, and you can publish your games on Core so other people can play them for free. So Core is basically a load of free games within a free game. Yes, we are talking Gameception. How this differs to other online platforms is that this runs on the Unreal 4 engine, meaning the games look fantastic. But not only that, the game's creators get a much better cut of any revenue. What this basically means is that you, as the player, get to experience thousands, and I literally mean thousands, there's over 20,000 games in this, of fantastic looking cool games that were actually created by gamers for gamers. You also get your very own avatar that you can take with you across different games, and you can complete quests to unlock new customization options, such as emotes and mounts. Core gave me a horse. Also, coming on October the 14th, Deadmau5, he's launching an interactive music and entertainment experience exclusively on Core. It's called Oberharsley. This isn't just a virtual concert, but a constantly evolving online world for fans and friends alike. So if any of this sounds appealing to you, check out the link in my description and in my pinned comment, where you can check out Core games for free. If you download Core using your Epic Games account, you'll receive these exclusive cosmetic items as well. Anyway, let's get into the game. So this is the Core world. It's like the hub of everything. And this is me, surrounded by loads of random people. So as you'd expect, you can run around, jump and all that. You can mount. Do you remember the mount things I showed you? Mine's a boat. Look how cool that is. Yarr! Oh, look at this. That's a quarter pipe. Oh, nice. Oh, I did not know all this was a thing. Look, there's like actual levels and stuff. Let's get off my boat. Right, so this is the Core hub. And there's all sorts going on. So there's different areas. There's like most engaging games over there. At the start of this video, we're gonna check out some solo friendly games. And then at the end of the video, I'm gonna play with some of my Discord server at multiplayer games. All right, so these are a few of the different games you got to choose from. There's a lot of variety here. You can also go into the menu where there's literally thousands and thousands of games. All right, so I spent a bit of time browsing to find some cool games to play. And we've come to this one. This is called Arcade Planet. And yes, we're taking the Gameception one step further. We're going to be playing a game inside of a game inside of a game, because this game, it has arcade games inside it. So we're playing Flappy Dragon, which is a Flappy Bird remake. Bollocks. Oh, we made it 3-1. Oh, boy. But look, there's loads of different arcade machines, all sorts of different games, and there's even a prize shop. So these are all things that you can put in your player. You can get a mushroom hat. Who doesn't want a mushroom hat? Or the rather tasty looking strawberry cap. But my mind is a little bit blown, if I'm honest. Like, how did someone make a game with arcade games inside of a game? Like, what? All right, let's play Block Stacker. I wonder what this is a ripoff of. Here we go, right. It's even got the music. All right, that looks good there. I'm actually not very good at Tetris. Oh god, I really need some vertical ones. All right, there's one. Wang you down there. Thankfully, there's another one on its way. All right, ready? Down the right side, let's get some fat points. Oh yeah. Oh, we could have got a 4. Just a 3. A 3 will do. 3's not bad. Pin... No, there can't be pinball. You're kidding me. There's a pinball machine. All right, there you go. We're up the top. Oh, I fell down again. Back up the top. We need to get in the skull somehow. Yes, skull! Oh! He clings to his mouth. Yes, we're in. Oh, he's glowing. Why is he glowing? Oh, I came out the cannon. Multi-ball. Oh, I love pinball games. Oh, it's all going in the mouth now. Look, we got another one. Does that mean we're going to get double multi-ball? Yes, the cannons. Boosh. Boosh. The points are racking up now, boys. I am a sucker for pinball machines, as you may have noticed. It's hard to imagine this is a game within a game within a game, and I'm having this much fun. No, we're knocking that skull's teeth out. There you go. Oh, the one's nearly in. They're nearly in. Oh, we've lost a lot of balls. Yes. All right, there's another multi-ball on the way, and I want to see what my high score is, how I compare on the leaderboard, because all these arcade games, they have leaderboards as well. More multi-ball. It's just constant. All right, there we go. 151,000. We got 30 coins for that, but we didn't rank on the leaderboard. So anyway, let's play another type of game. Maybe some sort of grinding game, like an upgrader, like a clicker. Bound to be one of these in these shores. Oh, God, look. Look how slow I am. I'm so slow. What I love about Core Games, like, there's so much variety. I did not expect there to be so much variety. I sort of thought it would all be sort of like just shooter games, like, because it looks very Fortnite-y. Let's not kid ourselves. It's the same engine. Unreal 4 engine is the Fortnite engine, but that's not the case at all. There's literally everything. So this one, I think it's sort of like a clicker. So click the mouse to gain speed. So as we click, you see we're slowly getting faster and faster. Right, we can buy a pet, and that adds 100% onto each click. So we can buy an egg. It costs 100 speed. We've already got 300, so we'll take that. And there's our new pet. Isn't it adorable? And now when we click, we get 5 speeds every time. Never miss out on getting new pets. 3 identical critters can be merged into 1 upgraded pet. Okay, that's quite creepy. Why are they walking towards me? Go away! Right, we got 1,000 clicks. We can be reborn. Rebirth. Let's head over here, see what the sign says. All right, so basically this is like leveling up. We lose everything we have. See, now we're really slow again. Yeah, but we get an extra speed point every time we click. All right, sod it. I'm just buying pets. So I'm pretty sure we can merge these now. So let's just merge. Look at this. We've merged into whatever that is. A diamond chubby chick. So what do we get per click now? 13. Ooh. All right, so we can do that to get a golden. We can do that to get a golden. All right, so we've got 3 goldens. So I'm pretty sure we can do that to get another diamond. We've got another golden. So now when we click, we get 17. Oh, why are these games so addictive for me? All right, so because we've rebirthed, we've unlocked a new level, the Veggie Magic. To get to the gruesome graveyard, we need 6, as you can see on the padlock. We're going to head into here. Oh, look at this. What are these? Oh, these are like bonus speeds. Yes. All right, we can do a jump as well. Huh. Oh, cheeky 100 there. Right, so I think it's definitely worth rebirthing to unlock all the extra levels, because look how much extra I'm getting. Oh, we can buy different pets here. They cost a lot more, 3,000 speed. I think there's a chance of getting different ones, so let's buy one. The strawberry's gonna burst. We got a bee with no mouth. Do bees have mouths? Oh, look, we got a nerdy birdie. It's rare. That gets us 9 per click. Decent. The bees get us 6. So we're going to use the bees because they are the bee's knees. Oh, we've got a gnome. He gets us 7. So that's better than a bee. Right, I'm going to get to the rebirth. Let's do it. But we've unlocked a new area. If we can click faster, we can get there quicker. Look. And this is the new area. What are these? Oh, yes. They get way more. Look. So a white ring gets us 62. A green one gets us 93. And a blue gets us 124. Right. All right. So let's see what the pets cost here. Oh, it costs 10,000. Right, we got some collecting to do then. Look, I can even run backwards fast. Oh, if we can get a ghost, we get 15 per click. Yes, we got the epic, the ghost with the most. Now per click, we get 40. That's what I'm talking about. Look how cute they are, just following us. But yeah, right, so I think that's enough for single player games. I could literally play this for hours, but I want to check out some other games with some of my friends, some of my Discord members. So let's go take a look at those. Ooh, look at the light. It's so pretty. Right, so this is a game called Make Them Fly, and I'm playing with a couple of my Discord players. They're the guys in green. Right, so in this game, the idea is the floor disappears, but you can push people like that. There's also a moon door there, and you can see the edge of the map is being destroyed. See you, theory. So every time the level gets smaller, see you later. Oh no, come on, I can win this. Oh, he's on the edge. Oh, this is a battle. Oh, this is proper stalemate. Oh, he's through the moon door. I win. Champion found, look at me. All right, let's do another round. Let's see if my Discord players can do any better. All right, I want to kill Framps real bad. Oh, Framps is through the moon door. It's me and Zero left. Bog off, mate. Oh dear. Oh no, oh, jump him. Oh God, jump, no, he got me. Oh, that was a tough battle. Oh, Framps. Right, keep moving. We're running around in circles. It's just me and Framps, the ultimate battle. See you later. Yes. Oh, I love it. Right, I am the champion of that round. Let's head back and pick another game. Right, so this game is called Talesworth Tower. But the reason I picked this game is because of this sign calling all architects. We've picked a game for architects. So Talesworth Tower is an eccentric monstrosity built by various artists and coders. Add an ingenious level of your own design. I have no idea what's going to happen here. Zero, we're away. What is that thing? I want it. Wrong button press. Oh, he pressed a button. Was it you? Oh, it's a puzzle game. Right, look. That's one. Press green. Press red. It's a red heart. There you go. Oh, bollocks, I pressed the wrong one. Oh, it's, there's shapes. Okay, I get it. So I'm just doing circles. Oh, look, you knobs. Look, both of you. Square is this one. Can you see there's a square here? Look at the background shape. It's a hexagon. Oi, hexagons are the best guns. Stop pressing other ones. Look, it's this one. One of you get the others. I'm getting triangle. Because I'm an engineer. I like triangles. Triangle, that's me. That's this one. All right, hexagon, that's you. We did it! All right, now we're on to the next puzzle. So we go through this, oh god, I'm not standing in that. Rampers, make sure it's safe. It doesn't look very safe to me. Oh god, is that safe? Okay. Tornado tubes. This looks really, really dangerous. Oh, it proper farted us out. Right, we landed in some sandbags, and now we're in the next puzzle. Oh look, we got different guns. I got a gun. Equip turkey cannon. Okay. Do I shoot the target? Oh my god, a giant turkey came out. I assume they're doing the same over there, are they? Ready? Boosh. Right, one more turkey. Turkeys are done. Come on, guys. You are slacking. Right, where's the cows? I'm going to do cows now. Oh, I missed. Boosh. No, I missed again. Boosh. Thank you. Man, cows are heavy. Compared to a turkey. Oh, it's so far. Got it. What a shot. Proceed to the exit tube. We did it, guys. The engineers are storming the tower. Huh. I do like the tornado tube. Oh, I swear I just hit my head on there. Did you hear that donk? Right, so for this next one, we're going to do a tour of the Taj Mahal. Whoa, look at this. You can see in the mist back there, we are at the Taj Mahal. Having a look at... I'm not sure that's there in real life. But yeah, look at this. It's like super realistic. Although I'm still dressed as a pirate. I should probably use the stairs rather than just jump over the barrier. Look how big this thing is. Let's go have a wander. Oh, this is quite nice. The fountains are like... They have sensors on them. They turn on as you run past them. Right, this has actually given me mega flashbacks to being a kid. So I used to like a bit of art as a kid, but I never really dabbled in it outside of school. But one day, I was watching... You probably won't believe this. I was watching a Bob Ross episode, and he drew the Taj Mahal, and I enjoyed it so much that I made my own copy. But aside from that, I don't really know too much about the Taj Mahal, so it's quite cool doing a little tour. There's also eggs to find, as you can see in the top left. If we collect all the normal eggs, then we can fly. And then if we find the rare egg, which I'm going to guess is probably on the roof, then we unlock that portal that we saw. Oh, look, I found one. That's not a lily pad. It's an egg. Ooh, confetti. Man, there's like proper woods and everything. This is cool. These are some big ass trees. Oh, look, another egg. Cheeky. All right, we're in one corner. Where to next? Excuse me, have you seen any eggs about? I'm trying to find some eggs. No. Oh, okay. All right, so this, I'm having to sit down on the bench. Cannot see any eggs anywhere. Have you seen it? Oh, there's one egg. Yay. Oh, God. Is your head okay? All right, it's the human jumping contest. 360. Oh, I actually did it. Nice. Reverse jump. Oh, nice. All right, let's go check out this building. Oh, look what I see. Look what I see. This is the last egg. We can fly after this. Ready? Wait for it. Boosh. We can fly. What's fly? Space. Whee. Oh, God. Look at my body. Right, you know where I'm going. We're going up to the very top. There's got to be something good up there. Oh, I think I can see it. It's like a floating golden egg. It could just be an Easter egg in tin foil. Oh, look at it. Look at it. Oh, wow. And look at the view. You can really see how big this map is now. It's huge. Anyway, I will collect you. Ooh, collect all rare eggs to unlock the portal. Right. Actually, whilst we're here, as that's so pointy, I'm going to line myself up. Now, I wouldn't recommend this at home, people. I'm doing it for the good of science. Ready? Oh, God. Oh, God. Right, so here's the portal. It's now whirling away. Let's see what's in here. Whoa, where are we? Are we inside it? Why are there paintings of eggs everywhere? Oh, what is this? What is this? Reveal your trophy? Yes, please. Whoa, what is this? What's in it? What's going to be in it? What shape is that meant to be? Anyway, let's go check out the next game. All right, so this time we're playing some mini golf. Yes, there's mini golf in this game. Oh, look at that. Hole in one. Hole in one. That was my first attempt at mini golf. And we just got a hole in one. Oh, there we go. I got a par. Oh, me and Broken Egg. We both got a hole in one. All right, let's full pelt over this. Nice loop the loop. Oh, Dolan, he just got ahead of me. But I'm in four hits as well. Still winning 7 points. Where are we heading? Let's have a look at this. This shows like the route. So we sort of want to go pretty far, I think. Sort of like that. All right, this is where my snooker skills come in. Oh no, someone's finished. So we're on a time limit to finish. Oh, there's the hole. We're so close. Oh, are you kidding me? What a waste. Is that a giant donut? Okay, we've got to jump the donut. We'll do a half. Oh, half was perfect. Putt to the finish. Birdie under par. Oh, look at that. That was close. We nearly overshot that. All right, now a nice putt to finish out there, I reckon. Come on, ball. Come on. Yes. Birdie. 19. I'm just about clinging on to first. All right, so this level, we come down here, go through the tube of doom, around a... Oh, God, it's quite complex. Just sort of... I'm going to do 3/4 power. Oh, God, we're over the top of the... No, that's not fair. Oh, I bounced out. That's because I bounced onto a ball. Come on. Oh, no. Yes. Oh, I just about did it. 8 strokes. And I don't know how much power. Maybe just under 2. Oh, did you see that? Dodgy physics there. Just ignore. This one, I'm going just full power as straight as I can. See you later. I was worried that was a hole there, but it's actually glass, which is pretty nice. Power. Oh, no, I hit another ball. It's okay, though. It's okay. What is this? What is this? We're in some weird, like, force field. I don't even know what way's forward. All right, full power. Boosh. Oh, we're just about in. All right, power. Oh, no. I tried to rush it. Never rush. One little putt into there. That was not our finest moment. Oh, maybe it was. We're top. Somehow we're top. Oh, 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 oh. Stay up. Stay up. Where's the hole? The hole's there. If I can not cock this up. Birdie. Oh, God, that might be too much. All right, and the question is, do I go for the putt? The snooker rebound putt? Yes. Oh, no. Something happened. Oh, I thought I was going to get that. Quick, quick, quick. Yes. Oh, just about got it. I think if you don't finish, you get like 10. I reckon there's a ramp there. Can you see that? Oh, look, zero just did it. It must be a thing. Boosh. Oh, no, over the top. Right, slightly less than full power. So we'll go about there. Ready? What a jump. Straight down the hole. And now we've just got to get into the actual hole. Okay, let's rebound off this. Boosh. Oh, nice. Oh, the double bounce and we're in for a par. Not going to lie, I'm still absolutely smashing the leaderboard. Trying to stay modest, but I'm doing all right. All right, I reckon let's just stay down this side. What a putt. What a putt. Oh, if I had a bit more power, that would have been in. All right, I'm going to be on just under 3/4. Oh, look at this though. We are dropping way down. All right, I'm going to head over that way, full power. Oh, maybe too much power. We did a bit of Tony Hawk's quarter pipage. I'm going to go just over 2. Come on. Oh, yes, eagle. And look how many points I got, 69. I want to throw the last one. If I can get a hole in 0, I have achieved. About there. Oh, it's looking good. It's looking good. That's how you get the hole in 1, though. Quick, Matt. Quick. Yes, we got a par. We got a par. And there's the final scores. I got 72 points and smashed my Discord members. Sorry, guys. Yeah, that was fun, though. All right, so me and Zero, we're going to play some Blizzard Mountain. This is like an obstacle course. We're going to race. We're going to race. Okay, Zero? Right, let's go. This really reminds me of, like, Destiny. Like, I used to play Destiny quite a bit, the FPS, but it had, like, a third-person sort of, like, third-person area. The hub or something. Right, we got to a checkpoint. So we're on the cracker section of the obstacle course. Right, we're nearly along the crackers. I am going crackers. We're at another checkpoint. Yes, in your face, Zero. Right, now we're on. Oh, look at these sweets. They look so, like, cool and shiny. I don't know why. Just looking at them makes me really happy. Oh, now we're on Chocolate Fingerland. I love chocolate fingers. I remember when I was a kid, my mum had, like, a cooking book, and they made like a chocolate finger fort. It looked amazing. It had like a drawbridge like this one, like made out of chocolate fingers. So cool. Another checkpoint. I don't know where Zero is. He has given up. What is this? This is like a cheese mountain. We're quite high. Oh, they're wine bottles with cheese poking out. The classic obstacle. Onto the gingerbread man. Thankfully, controls on this are really quite nice. All right, I don't trust the snowflakes, but we're up onto the cupcakes. What if I go onto the snowflake first? So I'm a bit higher. Yeah, that's the key. That is the key. Oh, yes, checkpoint. Down this runway of a tube. Oh, you absolute idiot. But yeah, that was a handful of different games on Core. There's obviously loads of like different shooters and stuff. But I figured they're sort of the popular ones. You've probably seen those. I wanted to show you some of the more random ones like this and the Minigolf. But yeah, really recommend you guys go check out Core. It's completely free. And if you're really up for a challenge, you can make these games. These are all made by people just like yourselves. And don't forget to check out the Deadmau5 interactive music and entertainment experience. That's on October the 14th. But yeah, once again, thank you Core for sponsoring. Peace, love, and ice boats. And I'll catch you guys next time. Bye.